A fresh bucket of mud, you might say, being tossed in one of Maryland's hottest political races, and it's all over the issue of taxes.
And in the governor's race, Martin O'Malley is proving he's one Democrat who welcomes support of the president. I-Team lead investigative reporter Jane Miller is live in the newsroom. She has more with tonight's Commitment 2010 report. Jane?
Rod, Barack Obama has cut a radio ad for the governor, intended, it appears, to also push for voter turnout. The mudslinging is in new TV ads in that heated 1st District congressional race between Frank Kratovil and Andy Harris.
This was incumbent Democrat Frank Kratovil's TV ad last week.
Can you imagine paying 23% sales tax on everything you buy? That's an Andy Harris's unfair tax plan.
Republican Andy Harris was incensed, demanding Kratovil pull the ad, then fighting back with his own TV ad, one that started running this week.
False, misleading, phony scare tactics. That's what the press says about Frank Kratovil's TV ads. The truth, Andy Harris opposes higher taxes.
Kratovil counters with his own new ad. In it, he does tweak his claim about Harris's position on a national sales tax, which you have to listen carefully to notice.
The real Andy Harris buried in his website a promise to replace the tax code with a 23% sales tax.
Kratovil's previous ad made no mention that a sales tax would replace other federal taxes. Kratovil does make a new claim in his new ad, actually a label, calling his opponent extreme.
Andy Harris's extreme ideas will cost us.
Right here in this neighborhood.
Switching channels to the governor's race, incumbent Democrat Martin O'Malley returns to his hometown of Rockville, positioned in voter-rich Montgomery County, for a new feel-good ad about education. A new radio ad features President Barack Obama.
I've seen Martin work, and I know this governor has made the tough decisions to put education, safety, and job creation first. So stand with me, Barack Obama, in moving Maryland forward with my friend, Martin O'Malley.
Some Democrats around the country have kept the president at a distance for the November election, not O'Malley, in response to a question today.
So I'm very, very grateful that he's done this radio ad, and I hope that we'll see him in Maryland.
In fact, the president will make a campaign stop in person in Maryland for O'Malley next week. O'Malley is no doubt hoping that Obama can inspire Democratic voters who skipped the primary to get to the polls in November. Also coming to Maryland this week, New York Mayor Michael Bloomberg. He, too, will stump for O'Malley in the governor's race against Republican Bob Ehrlich. Reporting live from the newsroom tonight, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.